Good afternoon, good day, whatever it is. This is Michael Bradshaw. I'm a researcher in the Friendly Society's story. The Friendly Society story is about social history of Bermuda. We will be looking at from the aspects of emancipation, getting ready for the emancipation, August the 1st. What does it mean? What's it all about? How does it relate to Bermuda? And if you're talking about emancipation, you have to talk about the Friendly Societies when you're talking about the Bermuda story. Because the Friendly Societies made emancipation. And not only did they make emancipation, but we're going to go on to talk about the celebration, commemoration of emancipation. Two distinct things, celebration and commemoration. And that's more than just cup match. So we're going to go through that, get a better understanding of that, and come back, wrapping it all up, talking about the Friendly Societies, who they were and what they were, what makes the Friendly Societies of Bermuda unique, what makes us as Bermudians unique, not just as black Bermudians or white Bermudians or Bermudians supporting Somerset or St. George's, but in Bermuda's social history, the Friendly Societies and their work has been fundamental for providing that background for where we are in Bermuda and Bermuda's social development. What is emancipation? Emancipation came in 1834. Simple freedom. Guy said, hey, you're emancipated, you're free, get off my land. But surely that couldn't be emancipation. Emancipation must have evolved more. One of the things that Bob Marley said, emancipation is more than just someone telling you that you are free. It is what you do to make yourself free. You must emancipate yourself. So when we have the emancipation coming about in 1834, again, emancipation being given by the British, but very much involved at the undercurrent of all this, our very own Mary Prince. Interesting thing, we'll talk about Mary Prince a little bit later on, was that Mary Prince was Bermudian, but Mary Prince, emancipation, came to the world. So in terms of people becoming free and needing to be successful in being free, but on their emancipation, the formerly enslaved were given nothing. They weren't given any sort of stipend. They weren't given 40 acres and a mule. They weren't given money. They were given nothing. But we all know that you need to survive. You need somewhere to live. You need something to eat. You need a job. And who came to the rescue but the Friendly Societies, those local Friendly Societies of Bermuda, who essentially said to the formerly enslaved, this is a change. This is a new world. You have a place in the new world. Your place in the new world will be guaranteed by us. You need things to survive, and we will see that you have food if you don't have food. We will see if you have somewhere to live if you don't have housing. We will give you a job, and all we require of you is a simple act. You are emancipated, you are free. Go out, celebrate, enjoy yourself. But tomorrow, come up, turn up to work. Do what you need to do to make yourself free. Work, look after yourself, look after your communities. And this was the contract that was made between the Friendly Societies of Bermuda and the enslaved or formerly enslaved masses of Bermuda that allowed Bermuda to transition from a society of bitterness, a society of jealousy, to a society that we now have where people can live together, not in perfect harmony, but can live together where we have evolved and we can now talk about the rights of others. We can talk about doing away with the injustices. We recently had a march that was about Black Lives Matter. The Friendly Societies were about showing that the Black Lives mattered, not just last week, but have mattered from 1834. So that not only was there freedom, but that freedom was made successful, that freedom was made enabled, because your freedom must come by your own hand, as well as something that someone gave you as a gift. 1834, emancipation, you're free. 1835, 1 year after emancipation, there is a celebration of emancipation. There is a commemoration of emancipation. We speak English. We know the words. English is a beautiful language, many words, but you need to be precise in your words. Celebration is different from commemoration. We have celebrated the emancipation of the slaves, the formerly enslaved, of those who've been treated unjustly since 1834, every year. We have commemorated it every year. Bermuda is the only place in the world, that has done this every year since 1834 without fail. This year, we will miss cup match. This year, we will not miss the commemoration and the celebration of the emancipation, because this event that you're now watching is part of that. You are a part of that. So let's quickly talk about the celebration. Emancipation, celebrate. What have we done so often when we celebrate? We eat a lot of food. We gather together with company. We play games. So, celebration of emancipation. Commemoration of emancipation. Commemoration of emancipation can take place in many ways. It can be going to some sort of religious house, church, mosque, whatever is your belief. Commemoration is also a reflection. What have I, as an individual, done with this past year that I have enjoyed, this life that I have enjoyed? What have I done? What have I accomplished? Commemoration among the friendly societies is men, as members, getting together, reflecting on our ethical values. And so, the commemoration is, in my mind, even more important than the celebration, because you can celebrate it anytime. But the commemoration is a bigger event. So we have celebrated it and commemorated it every year since 1834. Why did other places not do it since that time? First of all, not every place got emancipation in 1834. Bermuda was emancipated in 1834. You look at other places in the Caribbean and you'll find out it was a further 4 or 6 years before they were emancipated. You look in the Americas, the people in the United States was a further 30 years before they were emancipated. So understand and know about your emancipations, celebrations, and commemorations. We did it first, as I said, with family picnics. Round about the middle part of the 19th century, we got a funny English game coming here called cricket. And so the friendly societies, the lodges, included cricket in their fraternal games, in their celebrations. You had the picnic, you had a game, you had a cricket game. And the lodges throughout Bermuda all contributed members, because it was all a joint thing, all contributed members to these games and to these cricket games. And eventually we know that these games became so involved. They got so, shall we say, happy. They got so joyful. They got into that real carnival atmosphere. And you know, Bermudians often like to be sober, sedate, reserved, calm. So keeping with that mindset, we found that, you know what, maybe this cricket is getting so exciting and rambunctious, etc., that the lodgers need to give the cricket to a couple of sporting teams who will concentrate purely on the celebration side, on the fun side. Because remember, emancipation, celebration, emancipation, commemoration. Unfortunately, that has led to, we gave it to the clubs, gave it to them in 1902. They started the cup match and we have a major celebration. Cup match is the iconic Bermuda event. But how many people go to the cup match and don't even understand the commemoration aspect? That's an important part. We need to bring that back because this is part of your history if you're watching this. Not just if you're watching this in Bermuda, but this whole idea of commemorating emancipation is something that belongs to the world and should be recognized and celebrated throughout the world. The cup match is Bermuda. That is our celebration of the emancipation, but the commemoration is something that's more important. So what the Friendly Societies presently do is we have on the second Thursday after cup match, we have something called the Good Sportsmanship Award, the Cup Match Good Sportsmanship Award, in which we focus, again, the aspect of commemoration, not on the cricket game as such. The cricket game is important. We have the two teams attend. We get the umpires who do the game, they attend. And we bring everyone together to talk about what was a significant event during the game which allowed one of the participants, going back in that historic vein, to demonstrate good sportsmanship. Because remember, we are commemorating emancipation. We're commemorating the history, the path that our forefathers have trod as they've moved from people who were newly freed, formerly enslaved, considered unsophisticated, considered stupid, considered not capable, to this new world, this new life, where we have progressed now. And we want to recognize that in doing that, one of the most important things was working together, cooperation. Again, something coming from the Friendly Societies, the idea of all for one, mutual help, self-help. And so when we play this game, this team great game that is cricket, it's not just about winning. It's important. It's not just about winning. It's how you play the game. What are your values? How did you carry yourself on the field? And so in talking about that sort of thing, it makes me think of an event where the sorts of things that have won the award, you know, someone being out there making a fantastic catch and having the courage, having the honesty to be able to say it was not a fair catch and tell the umpire that. Someone being out there making almost a great score and being told you're out by the umpire. And instead of getting upset and a little of those bad words, bad actions, knock down the stumps, carry on rude, act up. Graciously, acknowledge the umpire, put your bat on the arm, and walk away. Being a man about it. Because life is not always fair. Life, most of the time, is not easy. It's how you handle, not the easy things in life, the hard things in life. It's how you handle, not the things that are fair, but the things that are different, the things that may even be wrong. That's good sportsmanship. That's self-respect. That's respect and recognizing that your actions not only govern you and describe you, but describe those who are like you, be your family, be it people from your church, be it people from your school. And so this is the whole idea of the Good Sportsmanship Award, to get a focus on how people can work as individuals for the betterment, and as a team, and as representatives of each other for the betterment. And those two things come together as we talk about, as I said, the emancipation, 1834, what it meant, how we've moved, celebration and commemoration of emancipation. It's my wonderful, enthusiastic duty at this point to record a few thanks, a few acknowledgments. First and foremost, I must be thankful that one, it's another day. I've been able to live through another day. I've been able to, having prayed about this earlier, been able to gather my thoughts and make a presentation that I hope will be clear and sensible to you and encourage you to find out more about Bermuda, find out more about these topics. The opportunity for this has been provided by a community and cultural affairs. I acknowledge the minister, Mrs. Levita Fogo, I'm not going to acknowledge the minister too loud because we're still too close to cop match, and she and I have a little thing that goes on with some citizens and George's. But, Madam Minister, thank you very much. Kim Dismont Robinson, Dr. Kim Dismont Robinson, we've spent a lot of time together. Again, I'm glad you and Ms. Carlita Lodge thought of me when you wanted to do this, and I hope you are pleased with the result. I've certainly enjoyed it. I'm thankful for the opportunity. I'm thankful as well for the chance to meet Keane Dickerson. We've had a quick nudge get together, found out a little bit about him. I'm finding out a little bit about what to me is this different world of social media. The last thanks must go to you, the person who's watching, because you've bothered to take your time. Life is valuable, time is valuable, to share in this. Because if you're watching this and you go through it, you're sharing. And I hope that you've enjoyed it. I hope you've learned something. I hope you'll look at it more than once. I presume you can do that on the social media platform. And that you'll encourage others to look at it. And if you want to find out more, you can get my email from Dr. Kim Dismont Robinson. Or I can quickly say it's mikedelemb@gmail.com. And there's something on Facebook, Bermuda Friendly Society Supporters Page. Check it out. Hope you enjoy it. Hope you get involved. I hope you do more than just enjoy it, get entertained, but like people did and like Black Lives Matter say, do something. Do something. Help yourself, help others. Thank you very much for your attention. I look forward to meeting you.